Our next topic is cloning. There are several types of cloning, and we're also going to introduce you briefly to stem cells. So cloning is making an exact copy of something, genetically identical. But it's important to note that cloning includes cloning of genes, cells, and organisms. So cloning a gene is when you just copy a single gene. And this is used regularly in biotechnology, especially with recombinant DNA. Remember when we talked about earlier about mass producing medications like human growth hormone? There we're cloning a gene and then inserting it into a bacteria. So this type of cloning is really common. Cloning a cell, this is when you're making an exact new copy of a cell. We'll get to this soon in this class. This is the definition of mitosis. Your body does this when it's building and growing or needs to replace old cells. So this form of cloning, again, is not controversial at all. It's a normal, healthy process. There's another process called therapeutic cloning, and this is how you make additional copies of cells. This is used a lot by researchers. Maybe you're studying a particular kind of cancer cell and you need more so that you can continue your studies. You're going to use therapeutic cloning. This is also what is used to maintain stem cell lines for research. So it's the third kind of cloning that gets the bad rap. This is cloning an organism, creating an entirely new individual with exactly the same genotype. And cloning, probably most famous, is Dolly the sheep. The sheep was cloned. And the way this works is you take the nucleus from an individual and you take an egg from the same species and you suck out the nucleus of the egg and you put the complete nucleus from the original organism in that egg. Then you implant the egg in a surrogate mother who then carries that new embryo until it's born, and that is a cloned organism. Again, there's a lot of bad movies about creating clones of soldiers and that kind of thing. We are not at that point in research. About a decade or so ago, there was a researcher who said he cloned humans, but then through the peer review process, it was determined that he had made up the data, and in fact, that was not the case. There are private companies now that will take samples from a beloved pet and create a clone for you. So for only $70,000, you too could have an exact genetic copy of Fluffy the cat. Even though I think we know from this class that just because your genetics are identical does not mean you are identical as a complete individual. This video will introduce you to stem cells and give you kind of an overview of how they work. There's a few more topics that I want to cover in biotechnology, bioremediation, biomimicry, and who knows what I'm going to keep adding to this lecture. Bioremediation is using normal and genetically modified bacteria to clean up toxic environments. And this video will give you an example of this happening here in California. Biomimicry is a fascinating way that engineers and designers can look at nature and use that information. This is one of my favorite videos from the class, and I hope you enjoy it. And who knows what's next? Some of you may be involved in new discoveries involving biotechnology and these new applications for how do we take what we have learned about cells and proteins and natural ecosystems and apply them to better human lives.